Just in that snippet you see right there, the new movie, The Public. It's written, it's directed by Emilio Estevez, and co-stars our guy, Rhymefest, and it shares the story of a public library that became a haven for the homeless residents during a very fierce winter storm in Ohio. So Rhymefest and Emilio, they're here with us now. Good morning, guys.
Good morning. Thank you. Thanks for having us.
It's good to have you in. So I want to start with you, Emilio, and the genesis of this film.
Sure.
Which is loaded with a lot of stars, which we'll get to, but it basically was an impact that you felt from an essay that you read from a librarian.
That's right.
Who said libraries become de facto homeless shelters,
and librarians have become de facto social workers and first responders. You know, a lot of librarians now will carry Narcan and administer it to individuals who are experiencing an overdose. So that's not what they went to library school for. That's not what they trained for. So this essay was written in 2007. So I've been working on this for 12 years. I read the essay. I was inspired by it. Yeah, man. This is a long journey.
Sounds like a passion project.
It's a mission.
Yeah.
This is a mission. This is a story that I, again, I wouldn't let go of. It's a film that I thought was important enough to make. And I think, sadly, the movie is more relevant now than it would have been had I made it 10 years ago.
Yeah. And Rhymefest, you've been open about your dad's struggle with homelessness, right?
You know, my dad had been homeless for 30 years. I didn't even know where my father was. But when my father and I first met, the place he wanted to meet me at was the library, because that was the one place where...
Just look at your father right there.
Yeah, that was the one place where when my dad and I met, he had dignity. It was a professional atmosphere. It was a place where he felt comfortable meeting me on equal territory. So for me to be able to do this film was just amazing, because when I put on the outfit and I looked in the mirror, I saw my dad and myself.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And it was part of his story was chronicled in a film called In My Father's House. Mm. And my mother saw that on television. She says, you know, I know you're casting your film right now, but have you thought of this gentleman as part of your cast named Che Rhymefest Smith? She doesn't talk like that. But for the purposes of the show,
his mom's way cooler.
So I said, no, I haven't seen it. She says, you need to see it. You need to understand who this guy is and if there's a spot for him in the film. So I saw the documentary. I tracked his number down. We started a dialogue, and I said, how do you feel about acting? He says, man, I've been acting my whole life.
One thing we know for certain is our guy Rhymefest is as talented as they come.
Certainly. I have to ask you though, Emilio, you said 12 years working on this project.
That's right.
What did you learn? What culminated in those 12 years?
So, you know, we all have a story about how an individual experiencing homelessness may have gotten there. And I think we need to start parking our bias at the door, because we have no idea how that person arrived there. Mm. And what I think what people are really responding to about the film is it humanizes. Mm-hmm. It puts a face, it puts a name on individuals experiencing homelessness. And I think that's very important. If the film can serve as pushing this conversation forward, this is a crisis. However, homelessness is not a condition, it's a situation. So how do we help these people get past this unfortunate situation and lift themselves up?
Worth noting in this impressive project with a very deep message, a lot of star power in this movie.
A lot of cast.
Obviously, we've got Rhymefest, and we talked about how you guys came together on
this. That's right.
Gabrielle Union, Alec Baldwin, and the list goes on and on.
That's right. Christian Slater, Jeffrey Wright, Michael K. Williams, Jenna Malone. I mean, it's Taylor Schilling. I'm blessed to have attracted these individuals to come and play in our Sandlot. They're very busy, and for it to have their vote of confidence and say, hey, you know, I want to be a part of this has been it certainly raised the awareness and elevated the project to a whole nother level.
And not your first movie in a library set in Chicago.
No, that's right.
Also
that's
in the
right.
Breakfast Club.
That's right.
Any favorite memories from that?
It was cold. It was cold. Yeah, they had us out in Rosemont.
Yep.
Rosemont. Yep. Yeah, they were. They had us in a hotel there, and we were shooting. And from what I understand, they've turned that school now into the DMV. right? So anybody who's gone to the DMV out in that area recently, as
they're visiting a movie set.
That's right. They visit the Breakfast Club set.
So I have to tell you, I really appreciate you being such a good sport a moment ago when we were at the end of the break, because we had to do a famous
the Mighty Ducks.
Yeah, the Mighty Ducks. We had to do a cheer.
Right.
But let me just tell you, you made three people from the 90s very happy.
Uh-huh. Right. But you know, this is not the town for that. They don't necessarily like the Ducks.
It was just that 10 seconds. We won't ever do it again. We won't ever see it again. But what do you remember about that movie? It's certainly exciting.
About the Ducks?
Yeah, sure.
Well, I mean, you know, when you're a young actor and you get cast in something, you never know what's going to happen. I mean, with Breakfast Club, it's somebody said yes. So you go off and you do that job. Same thing with the Ducks. We didn't know it would become a team. We didn't know it would become a franchise. It was just sort of, you know, you show up and you do your job, and then it takes on a life of its own. The kids were great. It certainly got a ton of kids discovering hockey and skating west of the Mississippi. It was really predominantly a east of the Mississippi sport. Now, boom, the movie hits, and you got all these kids going outside and learning how to skate.
Emilio, with that movie, we'd be remiss not to ask, here in Chicago, Jussie Smollett was one of the young actors that film. He's
That's
making
right.
headlines right now
sure.
for not the best of reasons.
Right.
What is your take? Obviously, you knew a very young Jussie, but what's your take on that situation and what's going on right now with him?
Well, I think, you know, at the end of the day, the truth will come out. And I think that, you know, we're in a time, especially with the media, where it's so difficult to get away with anything. So why even try?
Yeah.
I think you just have to be your authentic self always, and always present that authentic self, because it will be revealed otherwise if that's not the case.
Jay? And speaking of reality, Rhymefest, you're on Keeping Up with the Kardashians this season.
What can
you tell us about that? You got to give us the scoop.
Well, you know, last summer, Kim Kardashian and I had some words, and I think I even came on the show about it. And but Kanye and I since then have been talking and we've rekindled our friendship. And so Kim invited me to come on the Kardashians so that her and I could have a conversation, because you can't be friends with a man if you're not good with his wife.
Hey,
that's good advice right there.
Yeah, that is the truth. That is the truth.
So we had a conversation, and you. When you see the episode, you'll see how we worked it out.
Yeah. Okay. So outside of that, you've just been very busy. You haven't. Yeah. We haven't seen you here in a little minute, but that's because you've been doing a lot with music as well.
Yeah, I've been on three world tours with DJ Jazzy Jeff, and we did some music. But also, I also did three songs
that's
for
right.
the public.
That's right.
So myself and Black Thought did some music. I did some music with a young guy named Masego, with some Chicago artists. So we're looking forward to, when the film comes out, also premiering some of the great soundtracks that we did on the film.
That's right.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Opening
well, thank
titles
you.
Track and title track. It's just
Can't wait to check it out. Thank you guys for coming.
Thank
we
you.
Certainly appreciate it.
Thank you for having
it.
Me.
It's an important story. The public opens in theaters on April 5th.